Hi guys, welcome to our channel. Before seeing this video, kindly subscribe my channel for getting upcoming videos. Now we are going to discuss about data transfer group instructions. What is data transfer group instruction? In this type of instruction, you are just transferring the information from one place to another place. It's called as data transfer group instruction. Here, the place is considered as a source register and destination register. What is the value stored in a source register? That content is copied and placed in a destination register. It's called as data transfer group instruction. These are the list of instruction comes under data transfer group instruction. We will check one by one. The first instruction, move A comma hash 05H. In this instruction, move the content from source point to destination point. This 05H is a source, accumulator is a destination point. Before execution, accumulator content 08. After execution, whatever value placed in immediate content 05H, this content is transferred to accumulator. After execution, the accumulator content is 05. Just copying the content, the immediate content is transferred to accumulator. This is the one possibility of a move instruction. Here, source point is immediate data. And second possibility, you can change the source and destination value. A comma at the rate of R0. It's another possibility of move the content from register to accumulator. Here R0 is a register. Before that you can use 10 symbol. This symbol represents the R0 register containing the address. For example, the internal RAM address is 0E. In this memory location, we can check the data 80. This data is transferred to accumulator. After execution of this instruction, first read the memory location 0E. In this memory location, you check the content 80. This value transfer to accumulator. Here the source point is indirect value or not. Here pausing the immediate data. And another possibility, move A comma direct. This direct is a direct memory location F8. F8 is a memory location. In this memory location, it contains 1 8-bit data 88. After execution of this instruction, in this memory location, whatever data is present, that content is transferred to accumulator register. Next one, move at the rate of R0 comma A. In this instruction, the accumulator is a source point, R0 is a destination point. Whatever value present in accumulator, the content is moved to the memory location. This R0 register, it holds the memory location. Before execution, some value stored in the memory location. After execution of this instruction, the accumulator content is 08. This value is transferred to the specified memory location in R0. After execution, the memory location data is 08. These are the possibilities of move the content from source to destination. The second instruction, move C A comma at the rate of A plus DB TR. The previous instruction, just you give the source and destination. In this instruction, you can point the source is a 2 register, A plus DPTR. And destination point is a accumulator. This DPTR is a 16-bit register, A is a 8-bit register. This DPTR, it hold the base address. Base address of the memory location. The accumulator, it hold the displacement value. Displacement value. First you write the base address, DPTR value 4100, displacement value 08. Just adding the two register content 08 plus 4100, you can get the new memory location 4108. Before that, you can use @ symbol. This symbol represents these two registers or hold the address location. It's a new memory location. In this memory location, whatever data is present, this content is transferred to accumulator. It's a function of MOVC A, @A+DPTR. Third instruction, MOVC A, @A+PC. This instruction also similar to the previous instruction. Here, instead of DPTR, you can use the program counter value. In this program counter value, store the base address. For example, this address location 4300. And accumulator, it hold the displacement value. That displacement value is 05. Just adding the two content, you can get the new memory location 4305. In this memory location, whatever content is present, FE, this content is transferred to accumulator register. Then fourth one, MOVX A, @RI. In 8051 microcontroller, there are two possibilities of accessing the memory. This X represents for accessing the external memory. Here, the instruction is MOVX A, @RI. This RI you consider as R1. R1 is a one type of register. This register holds the address location. This address location is point the external RAM. You can access the external RAM. The data is FE. This data is transferred to accumulator. After execution of this instruction, whatever memory location is held in a register R1, it specifies one 8-bit data. This data is transferred to accumulator register. Fifth instruction, MOVX A, @DPTR. The previous instruction, the external memory address location is 8-bit value. This 8-bit value address location, it containing one 8-bit data, the content is transferred to accumulator. But this instruction, the source point is a 16-bit, the external memory location also 16-bit. You just represent the external memory location 16-bit value 4236. In this memory location, it hold a 8-bit data FD. This content is transferred to accumulator. After execution of this instruction, DPTR hold the 16-bit address location. This address location point on 8-bit value. This value is transferred to accumulator. Then sixth instruction, MOVX @RI, (A). This RI considers R1 register. Here the source and destination points is something different. Here source value is accumulator and destination point is a memory location. That memory location is held in a register. It's an indirect addressing mode. This R1, it holds the memory location. Whatever value present in accumulator, here the accumulator content is 55. After execution of this instruction, this 55 is transferred to the memory location FE. It hold the data is 55. Seventh instruction, MOVX @DPTR, (A). In this instruction, you can access the external memory. This external memory location is stored in a DPTR register because we are using one @ symbol. This @ symbol represents this register holder or memory location. This accumulator is a source point. Whatever value present in accumulator, the content is stored in an external memory location. Here the DPTR hold the memory location 5300. Whatever value present in accumulator, here the value is 0F. After execution of this instruction, this 0F is transferred to 5300 memory location. In this instruction, you can access the external memory. Eighth one, direct. This instruction we already discussed in 8085 and 8086 microprocessor. The same function only here also performing. Here push the content from direct. Direct is a direct memory location. You consider the memory location 0E. The data is F8. After execution of this instruction, whatever value present in a direct memory location, this content is transferred to stack pointer. Now the stack pointer value is F8. Just to move the content from the direct memory location to stack pointer. Ninth instruction, pop direct. This instruction is opposite to push instruction. In this push instruction, the data get from the direct memory location, then this value is transferred to stack pointer. But pop instruction, whatever value present in a stack pointer, that content is transferred to the memory location. Here the direct address F3. Before execution, the data is F8. Before execution, F3 value is F8. The stack pointer content FB. After execution of this instruction, whatever value present in stack pointer, this content is moved to the direct memory location. After execution, this value is replaced to FD. Just copying the content from stack pointer to the direct memory location. The next 10th instruction, exchange A comma at the rate of or 3. This instruction just exchanging the content between the two register. Whatever value present in or 3, this content is transferred to accumulator. The accumulator content is moved to or 3 register. Before execution, or 3, it hold the memory location 0E. It point the data F3. Accumulator content F8. Before execution, R3 memory location encode the data F3, accumulator content F8. After execution, the content from accumulator is transferred to R3. R3 content is transferred to accumulator. This content is moved to here. This content moved to here. Now the memory location 0E, it hold the data F8, accumulator content F3. 11th instruction, XCHD A comma at the rate of R2. In this instruction is similar to the exchange instruction, but exchange instruction you consider the 8 bit values. In the source and destination, the whole value is transferred from source to destination and destination to source. But XCHD A comma at the rate of R2, in this instruction only you concentrate the lower 4 bit value. Only you transfer in lower 4 bit value from R2 to accumulator, accumulator to R2. It's a concept of XCHD. Before execution, accumulator content F3, R2, it hold the memory location, because here using at the rate symbol, the memory location is F3. It's an address. In this address, it hold the data F2. F2 is a data. R2 register, it hold the memory location. This memory location is F3. This memory location point the data F2. It's a before execution. Then after execution, first you will write the binary value of accumulator content F3. F2 equivalent binary number. Okay. So in this instruction, you concentrate only the lower neighbor, lower 4 bit value. After execution of this instruction, this lower 4 bit value from accumulator content is transferred to the F3 memory location, lower 4 bit value. This content is transferred to the accumulator. After execution of this instruction, the accumulator content is F2, not to register, it hold the address location F3. The data is F3. It's a data. It's a address. After execution, the accumulator content is F2. This register address location, it hold the data is F3. It's an example of a data transfer group instruction. In data transfer group instruction, we have multiple options to choosing the source and destination point. Depends on your requirement, you can modify the source and destination place. Thanks for watching my channel.